please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
If you're a motorcycle enthusiast graduating to your first big bike, the usual place to start would be the Kawasaki 650s or something like the Triumph Street Twin. But if you're going to take a slightly more ambitious leap, where you'll come to is this space, the sport naked segment, prices between 7 to 9 lakh rupees. That's where the good motorcycles are. You've got the Kawasaki Z900, you've got the Triumph Street Triple S, and now entering the space is another Japanese inline 4. That would be the GSX-S750. We saw it at the Auto Expo, but today we're at the Budh International Circuit and we're getting our first taste of Suzuki's entry into the sport naked class. This is the GSX-S750.
The Suzuki S750 replaces the old GSR750 and takes one, well, several leaves from the same playbook that the GSX-S1000 uses. The most obvious one, naturally, is the styling. You can immediately see the aggressive form that concentrates on the tank and engine area, while the rear subframe is a much smaller visual element. The headlight is also similar in nature, but I think it looks neater and better than the bigger GSX-S. But there is a subtle difference between the bombastic 145 PS bigger brother and this 114 PS Suzuki.
Suzuki's understood the formula really well. So the S1000 engine was based on the K5 R1000, the S750 is based on the K5 R750, and that means two or three things. One, it's detuned, so it's got more torque than the K5 R750. The throttle, hardly any vibration at all. It's a smooth motor, and whenever you roll on the gas, it produces the most glorious inline four howl you'll ever hear off a stock exhaust.
Suzuki does have updates to the old motor, naturally. New injectors, new ventilation holes to cut pumping losses, and other changes boost power to 114 PS and torque to 81 Nm, both higher than the GSR750. And the result is a beautiful power curve that is extremely linear and very comfortable to use for new and skilled riders alike. The presence of Suzuki's amazingly silent traction control with three modes makes the motorcycle very easy to ride fast no matter your skill level. And that's not happenchance either.
Suzuki designed it to be an utterly predictable and trustworthy motorcycle. And when you go into the corners here at the BIC, I think that describes it almost perfectly. So they've got custom-made Bridgestone S21s. They are specifically made for this motorcycle. That, the frame, the suspension, it just comes together so nicely. You can exactly tell what the bike will do when you lean it into a corner. Your knee goes down predictably. And I think the only thing I would change is the size of the feelers. This motorcycle has ridiculously long peg feelers. So your knee is down and your pegs are scraping, and it's not a pleasant feeling, but I think it's an easy fix and the rest of the motorcycle is just spot on.
To do this, Suzuki created a new frame. It used a twin spar front with tubular elements and a new swing arm, and it also brought new KYB suspension at the front and a new link type rear monoshock, both of which are preload adjustable. At the racetrack, the suspension felt supple enough as well as absorbent enough. We will see, of course, how real-world performance works later. The brakes are really nice too. The 310mm Nissan dual discs have ABS as well as a lovely bite as standard. Not much effort is required to slow this bike down. And so, does it require effort at all? Well, actually, it does. You only ever feel the weight of the GSX-S750 in side-to-side transitions. And at 213 kilos at the curb, without the Indian Sahari guard and front number plate attachment, this is the heaviest bike in the class, roughly 3 kilos more than the Kawasaki Z900. But the nice thing about the GSX-S750 is that its nature and feel are more important than its specification. This is a genuinely nice, extremely likable motorcycle. And at Rs. 7.45 lakh ex-showroom Delhi, it is priced well too. I can see a hard-fought comparison test coming to OverDrive soon, but that is a story in our near future. For now, let's return to this Suzuki.
So that is a sweetheart. Riding it at BIC, it's obvious that it is the three things that a motorcycle for new riders needs to be. It's sweet, it's predictable, and it's trustworthy, and those are three solid reasons to buy this. However, at the BIC, at a track this size, even the 750 feels a little bit quiet, and I really want to see what it does in the real world, where the world itself isn't quiet. Also, there it will have to compete with the Kawasaki Z900 and the Triumph Street Triple S, and I think that's going to be a solid comparison as well. But with a price, 7.45 lakh rupees ex-showroom Delhi, I think it's got all the tools it needs to show them a good time.